Hello. Today I'm going to be painting one of the last models I have for Night Haunt, which is Lady Unlinder. Brief history on her is that she is the Mortark of Grief. Mortarks are high lieutenants of Nagash, the great necromancer. And in life, Lady Olinder was a schemer who kind of worked her way up social ladders until eventually becoming engaged to a prince who then spirited away, I guess, him and his father in the middle of the night. And so she donned this fake persona of a mourning lady, vowing to mourn her prince. So through her lies and deceit, Nagash cursed her. How she falsely mourned in life, she so now will mourn forever in death, and cursed her to feel all the world's grief constantly. So she has just become an entity of pure grief, which sends anyone near her into complete and utter insanity. Just hearing her wailing is enough to drive someone insane. And for Lady Olinder, I kind of had a big issue, and it took me a while to start painting her because I wasn't quite sure how I wanted her to look. Initially, I was going to have her kind of be a more fancy version of my Myrmore Banshees, who I based off of the Silent Hill nurses, and I'll put a picture up here. But the more I thought about it, the more I was like, I don't really feel like doing that, her in that way. So eventually I settled on what I'm doing today, which is she's going to have a lot of like very light tones with her veil being very dark. So I've been going with I've been doing Shire's Purple along the whole veil, and then I'm going to be taking Warlock Purple, mixing it together for highlights, and then doing just Warlock Purple for additional highlighting on her veil. Her hair, I'm going to be doing Fog Gray, so it's very light, wispy, and what you'd kind of think of a spirit who has their hair flowing about them. For her staff she has in her hands, I'm going to be doing plate mail steel, and the stone set in the hilt is going to be vampire red. For her chest piece, it's chaos red as a base coat and vampire red for highlights. And then I am going to go in with mummy robes for a base coat of the rest of her robes. And then from there, I will be mixing basilisk brown into the mummy robes to paint into the recesses so it has a very aged, dirty look, similar to how I did the Banshees, but not as, not nearly as foul. Thank you. In all honesty, I didn't really love painting this model. Night Haunt are all very flimsy, but Lady Olinda especially felt extremely flimsy. You'll notice on the left and the right side of her, there are more kind of thicker sections of that model, and that is because I had taken some green stuff, rolled it out, and applied it to her, because unfortunately where she connects at her base is extremely thin. So anytime I would pick her model up, she'd just start shaking back and forth, and I thought it was going to break off at any moment. So I'd gone ahead and do that to give it a bit more stability. Tried to make it look like it was part of her wisps, but I mean, I had to still make them thick enough to where it'd be stable. So, not my favorite model to paint as of yet. But on the tabletop, I do love Lady Olinda. She is an extremely powerful unit, of course, being a Morgtok, which is specific to Age of Sigmar. I can't find the definition anywhere else. A Morgtok is basically a lieutenant of Nagash, and they are imbued with part of his necromancy. Part of his power. And so on the tabletop, she can be played as a general, even though she's not picked as your general, which to my knowledge just means she can issue orders 18 inches away instead of the 12 inches of a normal hero. She has a very good ranged ability that deals a lot of mortal wounds. I believe she has some sort of AoE effect, and then of course she hits pretty hard, as well as having two spells to cast as a spellcaster and two to unbind on opponent's turns. So all in all, she's a very good model to field, just wasn't my favorite to paint. Thank you. For her handmaidens, I'm doing a very similar scheme. As far as their robe colors go, they're also going to get mummy robes and then a shadow color of basilisk brown mixed in. Their hair, however, is going to be a bit different. I'm going to be using uniform gray, and I was going to go in with different highlights and things to kind of... But I thought, as soon as I started painting it, I changed my mind because the uniform gray kind of sits very well with that eucalyptus primer. And it just gives it a very withered gray look. So... With the attendants done, I'm doing their accessories. So one has a locked box, and one has a timepiece, an hourglass. For the jewelry box, I'm doing leather brown as a base coat, and then for the hourglass and the details on the box, I'm doing true copper. For the hourglass itself, I'm doing crystal blue and then mixing in some mummy robes so that I can do some highlighting on just the outer sections to give that illusion of light hitting it. Thank you. Now that all of those details are done, I am going to be taking Kraken Skin and Snake Scales to do the base coat of their arms and her attendants' faces. And then Snake Scales as a highlight. Now that the models themselves are completely done, I'm going to be taking Green Skin and Moldy Clothes to finish up her vines. And then I'll be going over with Dragon Red on the roses.
Thank you.
Okay, and the only thing left to do here is, of course, do the base coat of my favorite three colors to give it a ground texture, and then do matte black around the edges of the base. Okay, and here is what she looks like all finished. I'm fairly satisfied with this model. I feel like I probably could have done a little bit better of a job in some areas. It just feels like it's missing something. And unfortunately, I think that just comes down to the fact that I was not sure up until the moment I started painting her exactly how I wanted her to look in the end. So thank you for watching, and I'll have my last lieutenant and my final piece of my Nihon army, Raken or the Grim Hailer, coming up next. So, thank you.